Hey guys, it's Allie. Welcome to another Colors of Hope Crafts ASMR. Welcome to my channel. Tonight, as usual, we are doing a video while I wait for my hair to dry. But, although since I've got not olive oil, coconut oil in my hair, that might not happen. Or it might not get dry by the end of this video, but we'll see. So if you've never been to my channel before, I do things a little bit differently around here because it's a running joke that I belong in about 1850, or that I was born in the wrong century because the technology I'm best at was very useful in about 1850. I am a fiber artist, and I make fiber art videos in the style of ASMR. People who love fiber art but have never experienced ASMR videos get to enjoy ASMR video while watching a fiber art video, and people who have never heard of fiber art get to love ASMR, they get to listen to the video. And my goal with these is just to show how relaxing and fun fiber art can be. I hope you enjoy this video. If you like it, hit subscribe, comment, and let me know what you want to see more of. I do read the comments, because I do like to hear from you guys. Also, if you want to find out more about how to sorry, just making sure my microphone was hooked up. If you want to know more about how to support this channel and get some extra videos, you can visit my Patreon page. That's www.patreon.com/colorsofhopecrafts. Also, if you like any of the yarn that you see on these videos, you can visit my website, www.etsy.com/shop/colorsofhopecrafts, and a lot of the yarn that you see on this channel is available for sale on my Etsy store, and all of it was hand spun by me. And a lot of it was dyed by the wool itself was dyed by other fiber artists. So, now for tonight, we're gonna do a couple of things. One person had made several comments about liking the fabric that I make. So I would have to assume she was referring to the knitting that I do. So I'm gonna spend about 10 minutes here knitting. I'm gonna spend another 10 minutes or so just brushing your face with some of my hand spun yarn because it's super soft. And I know that there are that some people really like having their face brushed with brushes, but since I don't have brushes to brush your face with, I can brush it with hand spun yarn. And don't worry, the hand spun yarn is very soft. Alright, so I'm going to just sit here knitting until about the 16 minute mark. And I'm not gonna talk very much. You can focus on trying to get tingles from watching my hands move. And watch the colors all blend together. I do try to incorporate ASMR tingles, or the normal ASMR tingles, into my videos. So a lot of times I'll be talking softly or whispering or tapping on things or brushing in your face with fiber that I get in the mail. And I do my unboxing videos. I wish you could see how cute my dog looks right now. Oh, she's sleeping on it. On something I have on the floor. But I'm sure if I were to move my camera, she would get up. Getting ready to move has been very stressful for her. Poor little thing doesn't know what we're doing or if we're taking her with us. But of course we are. Those of you who don't know, Leia is my emotional support animal. and she will often make appearances in my videos. Because she and I are often hanging out together. I hope you're enjoying this. Now in the next row, I will have to look at it a little bit. Sometimes I can knit without looking at it, and sometimes I actually have to look at it. It's one of the nice things about knitting. Once I've done it for a while, it just becomes muscle memory and you can do it without looking at it. And the same is true for crochet, depending on the stitch that you're doing. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. And I'm going to cast off 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Seven, eight. And there are several ways you can do this, but should be 8. I have to do a double yarn over, knit 2 together, double yarn over, knit 2 together. Now get close up. 1, 2. Knit 2, stick it, the needle under, double yarn over, knit 2 together, double yarn over, knit two together. Okay, since we're getting close to the 10-minute mark, I'm gonna do this really quickly. Yeah, because I don't wanna go. Go too far past the 10-minute mark. But I do want to get past this section. Before I step, because can be problematic to drop yarn overs. And it's a lot easier to drop them when you're in the middle of a section and where you need to use them. If you join my Patreon an account, you can get access to extra videos, and in one of them I'm going to explain how to knit lace. And in that video you'll get to learn about how to learn about how to create these little holes here. Or rather, eyelets. I think they're called eyelets. I hope you guys are all staying safe. I know it's hard during the pandemic. But I really hope you're all staying safe. And thank you to everyone who's working the front lines. I really appreciate that. that's everyone from grocery store workers to doctors. And everyone in between. I saw a meme the other day reminding people that hospitals would grind to a halt without housekeeping staff. So if there's anyone who's on housekeeping staff who were out working at, or anyone watching this video who works on the housekeeping staff at the hospitals, just know I appreciate you. I just want to do a shout out to Emily H because she's been commenting on a lot of my videos in the last few days. I really appreciate it whenever I get comments, and I do read them all. I respond to most of them. So, I don't think I don't notice when you comment. We are about to the end of this section. Knit past that one section just to make sure the stitches stay in place. I'm actually making this as a commission piece for someone. and she sent me several art bats in exchange for me knitting her the shawl. And I've already started spinning some of it. Here. Can you feel that? Can you feel that against your face? Sorry, the other section took twice as long as I thought it would. But I hope you enjoyed it. And I hope you're enjoying this yarn made from Janet's Art Bats. Very colorful. I actually tore them up into little pieces and spun them into singles and then plied them together into a two-ply. It came out pretty fun yarn. There should be enough of this one so that if anyone wanted to like make a scarf or something with it, they could. Or if you, because I have several skeins that look similar to this. Or I could, I think we're gonna sell it in just individual skeins rather than trying to divide them up into 10 to 20 yard mini skeins. And so like I do for some. I think that makes more sense. Here's another one of them. Here's some locks. Those locks feel nice and soft. Almost gives me tingles, just brushing it on myself. Actually kind of does give me tingles, at least on my arm anyway. This is made out of mostly merino wool. And if you don't know, merino is incredibly soft. I hope this is relaxing you. This is my taste of springtime yarn. Made of merino and silk and faux cashmere and BFO. Oh, I don't think I told you in my last video, but my mom has at least 6 new lambs on her farm. They've been born in the last 3 weeks or so. And so, if you join my Patreon channel, you'll get to see a tour of my mom's farm. This is made out of corydell and Falkland wool and wool I grabbed out of a mixed bag of wool from art club. Corydell and Falkland isn't quite as soft as merino, but it's easier to spin with. And I mean, it's still soft, but merino has a tendency to feel like it's out of this world. Do you have any merino left in here? Oh, yeah, there's some. This one's made, it has a lot of merino in it. This yarn was a play on Find Your Fade by Drea Renee Nitz. I'm about 2/3 of the way done knitting that. I'll have to do a video. There's some other fun ones that has merino in it. Well, I really hope you've enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. And if you like it, hit subscribe, leave a comment below. And I will see you in the next video. Be safe. Stay healthy. And I don't know if any of you are into prayer or anything like that, but a friend of mine could use some prayers. Our family's having a lot of health issues, and one of them might have COVID. Her dad's disabled, so. She could use some prayers. So if any of you guys are watching this as are into prayer and that sort of thing, it would mean a lot to her and to me if you would do that. And I will be keeping you guys in my thoughts and prayers as well. I still think about you guys, even after I turned the camera off, and I really appreciate all your support. Thanks so much. Have a great night, guys. Bye.